So we are now going to try to make a 3D piece of art called a sculpture using pattern and cereal boxes. I think I'll actually hang on to that guy, keep him in the classroom. But you want a couple of cereal, cracker, food boxes, just any cardboard box that's thin enough for you to cut with scissors. Something to color with, crayons, markers, colored pencils, a pencil, and things to trace. Circles, squares. You want it to be about the size of your palm, though. So what you're going to do is cut out about six or seven shapes. That's a circle. You can make up shapes, make up more organic or free-form shapes. Okay, but nothing too small, nothing too big. About six or seven. So I have my pieces of cardboard cut out, and now I want to make a different pattern on each piece. And you will color those patterns in with your choice of materials. I'm going to go with markers today. And so think back to how we make a pattern. We repeat different elements. Repetition of color, of shapes, of lines, of everything combined. So you can start to, I'm going to start really simple. So think back to how you made patterns for your pattern drawing and start to add patterns to each piece of cardboard. You can create patterns with colors and lines and shapes. Notice how I turn the cardboard piece so it's easy for my hand to draw all over. Fill up the backs of your cardboard with color, line, shapes, pattern. I have created patterns on all of my cardboard shapes. Now comes the hard part, or the fun part, or the fun hard part. We're going to make a sculpture out of our cardboard. Where did I put my scissors? There they are. So, you can start by cutting a slit in one of your shapes, and then you can slide another shape into that slit. Hopefully, it's going to stand up, and you're going to keep doing that. Sorry, it's hard for you to see what I'm doing here. You're going to start doing that to build up a sculpture. And it will take practice and balance. And you may have to restart a bunch of times. That is part of working with 3D art, is we have to think about not just what it looks like from the front, but what is going on in the entire space around your art. Ta-da! See if I can turn it towards you. I really wish, I want him to stick up a little bit higher. I'll put him like this. There we go, much better. So you can put it together, take it apart a couple of times. It may completely collapse, in which case, start all over. Let's try it again. Okay, so I got another version and I actually learned something super handy to help it stay better. When you're joining two pieces, these I haven't put patterns on, but you want to cut slits in both pieces and then slide those together, and it will help them stay in the direction you want, and it'll make it a little more stable. So if you're having trouble, give that a try. When you present your 3D piece, instead of just taking a photograph of it, I would like you to video around your entire 3D sculpture. You can imagine you're giving a tour. You can imagine it's giant and we're really small. A lot of sculpture in public places is really huge. And so we get to walk around it and experience it from all different angles and sides. So when you finished this artwork, I would like you to try and do that and give us a tour of your 3D sculpture. Here is the 3D tour around my pattern sculpture. Notice how the artwork changes as I move through space. So sculpture depends on where we are and how we experience the artwork. The shapes and the entire sculpture changes as I move around. 3D pattern sculpture.